Hello guys, welcome to my channel, and today I have a colorful mixed media scrapbook to share with you with a big box. Now the size of the box is 14.5 inch by 15.5 inch. So 14.5 is the breadth and 15.5 is the length, and the height is 4.5 inches. So that is a pretty big box for the scrapbook, and the scrapbook inside is 12 by 12. So that's a full size kind of a scrapbook, and I have added binder rings. That is why I had to make the box a little bigger. As you can see, the box is white and it is covered with lace, and this is the paper that I've used for the scrapbook. This is some old world kind of wallpaper, kind of really fun and vintage papers that I've used to make the scrapbook, and they are really fun. I used around 24 sheets, I think a little more than that, and let me now talk about the box. As you can see on the border as well, I have added a little lace, and the front is a clear acetate window. I kept it such plain and white, so because the scrapbook itself was very colorful, and to bring out the colors, I thought to keep the box a little muted. So you can see on the inside, I've added some gold tissue. No reason, just to, you know, give it that glamorous feel. And this is the back, and let me put the box on the side, so you know we can talk more about the scrapbook. Now this is a scrapbook layout that I made a while ago, and I had posted it on my blog and other social media platforms, and I think most of you must have seen it. So while making, I was thinking that I want to make a scrapbook, and I want to use all the flowers that I've used on the top. And so while I was making it, I added two holes and decided to do a rainbow kind of a floral scrapbook that matched perfectly with the cover. Now on the inside, let us go, and you'll be able to see an array of bunch of colors. I kept the entire scrapbook rainbow colors, as you can deduce by the cover itself. So all the colors that I have used inside are on the cover as well, and I've used a lot of old stash of flowers from Itsy Bitsy, available in India. I think it's a little body brand, and it's available in Itsy Bitsy stores. So I had so much of old stash of flowers that I had no space to put the new ones. So I decided to use as much as I can, and trust me, I still have a boatload of them, lot of flowers. So I did not only use old flowers, I have also used new flowers from Itsy Bitsy, as well as some mulberry flowers and some prima flowers. I don't know, I've used a lot of different brands, but most of them, like 90% of the flowers that I used, are old. So the entire scrapbook screams flowers. Now you can see every page has got these fun picture mats, and you can put 3 to 4 pictures on each side. Then the entire scrapbook has got 7 pages, and counting the front and the back covers, that makes around 16 sides, so you can put 64 pictures comfortably. And the sizes are such that, you know, you can take you can add a big full size 5x7 picture on every side. So apart from the flowers, I've also given a lot of gold foiled leaf die cuts on every page, as well as white leaf die cuts, and I have embellished wherever possible. Every page also has this journaling tag that I have you know, color coordinated with the page. And you can see we started from maroon, and now we are going towards corals and magentas. So as we progress, you'll be able to see all the 7 colors of the rainbow. Every page has a lot of mixed media work on them. I started with stenciling, then I added cheesecloth, then I did a little embossing as well, but that's not very visible because I did not know where I'm going to put my flowers, so a lot of embossing has been hidden. But to compensate for that, I added gold heat embossed chipboard shapes, background stuff, and most of them are from expression crafts, some are from mudra crafts, Itsy Bitsy, and paperishes, and a little from Dusty Attic as well. These particular ones, the star ones, are from Dusty Attic. So this, now we are on the pink side, and let's talk about the stencils that I have used. A lot of stencils are from Crafters Companion, Prima Marketing, Itsy Bitsy, and Tim Holtz, of course. So I have tried to do a different kind of stenciling on each page. I think when the stenciling differs, the layout looks a different. So this is almost like building 16 layouts, and it took me around 16 to 20 days to build this entire scrapbook, because building one layout took me a day, and it took me a lot of time to figure out what colors I want, and I was searching. I didn't want to use my new flowers, so a lot of time went that, and I wasn't working for a very long time. I just worked for a few hours, and once the page was done, I would just move on to the next one on the next day. So anyways, now we are on the lavenders and the purples. So on most pages I did floral arrangements on three sides, on few pages I did on two sides, and on page like this, like the purple one, I did a single huge floral arrangement on the side. So I did such to balance the bulk on the layouts, because if we do floral arrangements on only one side, then it would get bulked up. So to manage the bulk, I have spaced and placed the floral arrangements in such a way that you know, even after the scrapbook was done, everything lay flat. And now let's talk about the embellishments that I used. I used chipboard embellishments. I also used some clay pieces that I made using the IOD molds, and those are in the lock and key lock kind of things. And then I also use some buttons which are from paperishes. I also use some metal charms. I think they are from Eno Greetings. Again, very old stash. And then stickers, of course, from Tim Holtz. These are, I think, small chat stickers. So on every page, I tried to add some motivational words like happiness, gratitude, and friendship and family. On few places, I also gave positive quotes like, do it now, or, look for the stars, or something like that, some positive quotes to make you feel happy. Anyways, a scrapbook like this does make you happy. And it really, really, at least made me happy. It's raining in Mumbai and it's really dull, boring, gray. And every year during this time, I always come up with something colorful. It's just something that I think I should do to break out of the boredom. So anyways, now we are from yellows to yellow ochres, and we are to the green. And this is almost the end. I think we have two more pages of green after this, and the scrapbook will be done. So I hope that you guys are liking what I have made. And I think this is the best way to use a lot of your supplies that you keep holding. As a crafter, you hold a lot of stuff, and sometimes you buy stuff for a particular project, and after the project is done, there's a lot that is left. So I had that problem, and I was having so much of stuff that I didn't know what to do, and you definitely do not want to throw them. So this is a good project. This is a good way you can use up all your stash. And on this page, at least you can see there's stickers, and this says make magic memories. And then there is a cute little clock. It was a brad actually that I added on the flower. So on my flowers, I tried to change the centers and just add something blingy to make it shiny, but I saved the centers that I rip off. So this is the last page, and it ends with a peppy green. I really love this green, and I saved it for the very end so that I can add it on a darker color paper and finish the project off. So I hope you guys like it, and if you do, then please hit the like button and leave your comments. And this is the back. You can see all the colors that I used, and everything is on the back. So this is what I have made, and if you have something to ask me, please leave your comments below, and I will be sure to reply back to you. So thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.